and meteorites falling from the sky. So all of these signs are showing us what time we're living in. And even the things that's happening on Earth, how you have famines on the planet. This is not the third happening. Every other day, there's some cyber attack occurring somehow, some way. Every single day, there's a major event that takes place. Like how you had a couple of days ago, the mass stabbings. Okay? And a couple of days before that, what you had is you have the police down here that are militarized and being deployed on standby now. So everything's going according to plan, according to the elites, and also according to the law. But really what it is the elites think they got everything down pat, but they don't. They're going to do everything that's going to involve this prophecy of this book, okay? And then they're going to go right into captivity. They're going to go right into slavery. And that new world order shenanigans is going to be null and void. It's what's going to take place. That's where we're at right now. That's where time is going to, that's what time is going to manifest. Them a parable, behold the fig tree and all of the trees when they now shoot forth. You see and know of your own selves that summer is nigh at hand. So likewise, when you see these things come to pass, know that the kingdom of God is nigh at hand. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass away until all be fulfilled. So the Lord said it again in Luke. So when you see the things, some of these things come to pass, such as the prophecies that involve that signify the end of this world. Know that your kingdom of heaven is coming to happen. And that's why we're out here to warn you of what's coming down. Because we know what's going on around this world. We know the prophecies, we know certain current events indicate certain things. So we're out here to foretell you, to tell you the forecast of what's to come. Alright? You got a lot of people out here, they watching different foolish shows out there like Stenton's and Amazing Race and that and this and that and the third. I mean, I don't even watch TV, so I don't even know what's going on. But I just know that people are so unaware of what's going on, man, on a spiritual level. But that's why we're out here, to do that job for you. Now, you don't have to accept what I'm saying. You don't have to agree what I'm saying. But guess what? What I'm saying, it's going to come into fruition within this world. This land here, or the other lands, the other countries thereof, are going to receive great destruction. That's what's going to take place. And you got people enjoying themselves because the sun is out. It's a Saturday and all that. And then some, but they're not bothered of what's going on. They're not bothered that their own government is setting them up. You know, for a big major current event to happen. And that their rights are going to be taken away of. So they're unaware of that as well. So at the end of the day, man, this is the same thing that's going on from the time of the beginning. You have people just doing what they had to do. Even though Noah was warning them for the flood, they were still doing what they wanted to do and they didn't really care. But guess what? We're doing the same thing now. And guess what? The majority of the people, they're going to get the same treatment. They're going to get the same treatment. Let's get that in 2 Peter, the third chapter.
Thank you.
This is the third chapter. And it says, knowing this verse, that this shall come in the last day, stop and spoken unto the old us. Let's jump down. We're going to jump down the verse. So, for this day, willingly are ignorant of that by the word of the Most High, the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of water and in the water, whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished. Okay, so the world of the world of Noah was the time when the flood came, when the flood was going to come. So Noah was born in the mass of the people at the time of the flood to come, but they didn't want to take heed and accept it. You could say, bucked up against it. Right? And then when that flood came, their eyes were going to drown them. When they saw that rain coming down, because during the time of Noah, what you had at the time. So there was no such thing as the rain. All right, but they didn't believe in it. So we met before.
Keep on telling you, your food is out of water.
It was out of water. You're going to have
to. Reuben comes before the garden and Asa.
I understand. I know what you're saying. That's how it's
true. No, I know who's doing that. Levi.
I understand what you're saying. We're going to go into Luke 21. Matter of fact, 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter. So it says, for this day, willingly are ignorant of that by the word of the Most High of heaven were whole, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water. So the people at the time was ignorant of the fact that she was going to have a flood coming down, because during the time of Noah, all you had was the dew that was coming from heaven. That's all you had. You didn't have no rain. There's no such thing as things with rain. But when that rain came down and created the flood thereof, then the people started to run towards the flood. The ark at the last minute. So it's the same thing like now. When all manner of hell breaks loose out here, the majority of people are going to be running to guys like us for the answers. But we're not going to give you the answers. Because it tells you in the scriptures that when all hell breaks loose, the righteous man, they're going to be dwelling in secret, roughly paraphrasing. Because they know it's a dangerous time. So we're going to be in secret. We're not going to tell you what you need to do. You're just going to have to just suffer it in the stress that you're in. Okay? Because that time is coming, man. That time is right around the corner. You see what I'm saying? So when a major cyber attack happens or whatever, or an economic collapse happens, and there's nothing but chaos going on around the world, don't come running to me. Because I was out there. Okay, the Lord has stretched out his hands towards you, but you decided not to do that. You decided not to do the words of the Lord the same. Okay, so we're going to read... out of the Holy Bible, we're going to read, 2 Peter's, the 3rd chapter, the 5th verse. And it says, for this day willingly are ignorant of that by the word of the Lord, the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water, whereby the world that there was being overflowed water perished. So that world is now long gone and perished now. It's finished. So it says, but the heavens and the earth which are now, are kept in store. Let's read it. Are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment. So what the Lord is going to do this time, and that's why the Heavenly Father set up the rainbow to signify that he was going to flood the earth no more. Like how he did during the time of Noah. But see, what the next destruction is going to be is by fire. So we're doing this same thing that Noah did, the same thing that Noah did, right? When she was out there prophesying for 120 years, pulling his heart out to the people, letting them know who there was. He walked past them. They even, you know, pay attention to what he was saying or even think about what he was saying. And guess what, when that flood, when the rain came down to drink the flood, the people got drowned. And when certain people saw the ark, they ran towards the ark from the flood. But they got drowned therein. And you got certain people that was near the flood that was hoping that Noah would open the door, but the door was shut. Which that was the spirit of the Lord to drown those people in the flood that didn't take heed anyway. So the same thing is going to happen now. When you start seeing the nuclear missiles fall from the sky, when you start seeing all hell breaks loose, guess what? Don't come running to me. Because I'm not going to give you the answers. Because I know that's what's going to happen. You're going to have certain people walking up to me, telling me, oh, I've seen you out there before. You know, I've seen you call on the name of the Lord. What's the name of the Lord? I'm not going to tell you a damn thing. Because now we're in the time, because now we're already being in a time of destruction. We're no longer in the time of mercy. Okay? So we're going to keep reading. This is 2 Peter 3, verse 7. For the heavens and earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. And the day of judgment and the perdition of ungodly men. Because the majority of people out here don't really care about the Most High. A lot of these don't even believe in the Most High. Okay? To even focus on the Most High. Because if a lot of you still, there'll be a crowd of people up here heeding to what I'm saying. But quite frankly, that's not the case. So what's going to happen to the ungodly men that's on this planet is they're going to get this. They're going to get this destruction, man, coming for them. They're going to get these nuclear missiles firing from one end to the, from one end to the sky to the other end to the sky. And when these bad boys hit ground zero, that's going to be their ass. And that's going to be it. Okay? But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing. Let's go into something else. Let's go into something else. So, you know, so that's the point, man. The point is that you gotta come back to the Lord. If you're so-called Negro, so-called Latino, Native American, you gotta repent and come back to the Lord, because you are the Hebrew Israelites. Okay, that's what you have to do. You have to repent and come back to the Lord. Because if you don't, you will be destroyed. There's no gray area to this. And you're going to find that out. I'm just telling you, but time is going to let you know the deal. You're going to find that out. That there's no gray area or no loophole. Okay? This is not my program. This is the program of the Heavenly Father. Okay? So we're going to get Ezekiel. Let me see. Yeah, here we are, right here. This is another good one, too. This is Ezekiel 21. I think I'll start from verse 20, verse 10. It says, matter of fact, verse 9. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go to Ezekiel 7. I'm going to go back there. This is Ezekiel 7, verse 3. Now is the end come upon thee, and I will send my anger upon thee, and I will judge thee according to thy ways, and I will recompense thee upon Selakia, and I will recompense thee all thine abominations, and mine eyes shall not spare thee. So when the Lord wreaks havoc or judgment on the world, there's not going to be no mercy. But now we're in the time of mercy to come. But there's going to come a time coming where there's not going to be no mercy. Okay? That's the time that we're coming into. And what you're going to have is you're going to have all manner of just violence in the land of it that you can't even explain. It's so much so that I'm going to try to be scared myself to a certain degree. But the difference between us and you people, we're going to be stable-minded, because it tells you the scriptures that wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. And the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So we're going to have that in us so that we'll be stable in that time. Okay, because we're taking heed, number one. Number two, Lord willing, we shall be delivered. So So it says we're going to get Ezekiel 7, verse 4. Mine eye shall not spare thee, neither will I pity, but I will recompense thy ways upon thee, and thine abominations shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Thus said the Lord, power and evil, and only an evil is come, or holding is come. That's right. The word F meaning time, and the word L meaning bad. So we're going to come towards bad times. Okay, you got these group of men calling themselves ISIS or ISIL. You know what I mean? Causing trouble in the world. You know, killing people and all of that stuff. Beheading people and all of that stuff. You got these groups of men out here that are doing rubbish, doing madness. But we all understand that those men are set up to cause trouble anyway. Okay, by certain central intelligence agencies. Set up to cause trouble, man. But they're going to cause trouble, and it's just going to invoke violence. It's going to invoke more violence in the city there. Because what you're going to have, you're going to have certain nations or certain people, they're going to be influenced by doing what these group of men have done. The mass stabbings and all of that stuff. That's going to take place. And then one thing is going to happen after another thing is going to happen. It's going to be one thing after another thing happening. And it's not going to be some small event that you see about in the news every once in a blue moon. It's going to be major events. Because we're coming into towards the day of judgment, the day of great travails and trouble on the earth. This is not no joke. Now you got some people don't shake their hand, or, you know, don't shake their head, or you know, put a middle finger up. That's cool, but that's not going to stop nothing. That's not going to stop anything. Okay, the word of the Lord is still going to go forth, and the practice is going to still go forth. Think about the Hebrew Israelites. According to the Bible, I don't know if you believe in the, Bible. Come closer for a minute, because I see that you guys want to, you know, you want to be quiet. What do you want to know? What do you guys want to know?
This is Daniel, this 12th of the nation of Israel,
That's right. So you know the look. So, you know, I mean, since you know that, I'm going to slip you know anything, because you might not know. Going to the Bible. Okay, he was born for Jesus Christ in the last. He only came and died for this nation. Why? Because it goes all the way back to the beginning of time. Now, I'm not saying that because it's my own ideology. I'm saying that it's going to establish a covenant going all the way back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So that covenant hasn't been fulfilled yet. So he's going to fulfill that covenant by doing what he said he's going to do from the beginning. Okay, because what's going to happen is he's going to have all the other nations of people. So what's going to happen is you have all these nations here. Before the Egyptologists or Black or One News came up with the media, went viral, right? We just flooded the stream on YouTube. But what it is they don't want you to receive this truth. They want you to be Lord, thy power have chosen thee, to be especially people to observe for more people that are on the imaginary, you know, cartoon, but this is real life. Okay, this is real shit. So, you know, at the end of the day, all this stuff right there is happening already. Okay, it's gonna get down to that. All this is gonna get down to that. So you wanna be one of those men that's gonna deliver. Okay? In these times over here, because it tells you a marginal chapter that there shall some things, there shall be some men that shall not taste in death. So they see a kingdom that has a promise. You want to be one of those men, don't you want to be? Well, it's easy if you got a business, you got to come back to your strength. That's what you got to do. And then what you're going to have is, that's what you want to be. So it says, I want to read another verse. So, I mean, if you want to know, so I mean, if you got something to say, but something to know,
Verse 28, you should not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead.
no print any marks upon you and the law. Okay, so you're not supposed to print.
You're not meant to cut your flesh, you're not meant to ritual, you're not meant to do it for a ritual for the dead.
No, but the thing about it is, the thing about it is, whether it was for the dead or the spirit, just like doing it, you're not supposed to do it. That's not the law, sit up to the law, basically. You know what I mean? You conduct yourself according to the law and the human life. So if you're putting marks on, you're putting tattoos on. Now, I'm going to say this, because you have certain guys in the truth that have tattoos. But they didn't know. They were sleeping. You know, but you can still repent of that. You know what I mean? But now that you know, you gotta kind of like, you know, make that move. Because, you know, if you want to be the living, you gotta follow the law. You gotta have fear of the law, follow at the same time. You know? So, I want to ask you a question. You said, like, why do I want to go?
Yeah. And then after this, then we have to shoot.
It says, speak to the children of Israel and bid them that they make themselves like them, that they make the bridges with the borders of the garments. Because your generation is put upon the bridges of the borders of the rift for you, as you see the bridges of the rift and the fringes of the rift. Which the fringes of this whole garment represents the laws, the 613 laws that we must keep. So it's spiritual. That's why we wear the robes and stuff like that.
We have the words all the time.
What's that?
So where did the other clothes go? Because we have the words, but then when it goes underneath the words.
Well, really, the reason, at the end of the day, right? Now, I might wear my regular shirt like that. That's just me going about doing what I do in the world. Because we all live in this particular world. You know, the reason we say, this bar is a sermon, I'm going to stand up. So, you know, it's never really captivity. You know what I mean? We do have to kind of like coincide and do it kind of thing. You know what I mean? But at the same time, this really what we should be wearing is the clothes. That's what we really should be doing.
Alright.
If you want to know more, you know, I'm out there. I'm going to start coming on here every Saturday. I'm going to see
y'all
every Sunday. Alright, I'll take it. Abomination shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Thus said the Lord, power and evil, and only an evil is come. Behold, it is come. So the evil times is going to come in these times real soon. And it's right around the corner. It is there and it is right around the corner. Okay, so since that it is, what's going on, bro?
This is 2 Kings 17, verse
Pittsburgh. Okay, okay. Well, I'll deal with him first now, but I'll deal with him. Alright, this is, and here it is right here. It says, check to the point. It says, I'll start from verse 17. Matter of fact, verse 16, it says, and they left all the commandments of the Lord their power, and made them molten images, even two cows, and they rode and worshiped all the hosts of heaven and served them all. They caused their sons and their daughters to pass in the fire, and used divination and enchantment to solve themselves evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke them to anger. And this is the point. Therefore, the Lord was very angry with Israel and removed them out of his sight. There are none left but the tribes of Judah only, because what your people did is your people did. Our northern Israel, like Samaria, places like that. So you go there from time to time and went from the Lord to the people that goes into it. And it says, and the Lord rejected all the seed of Israel, which is the northern people, and the people that delivered them into the hands of the spoilers until he had cast them out of his sight. He read Israel from the house of David. I'm going to jump all of it down to, it's right here, 23. It says, until the Lord removed Israel out of his sight, which is the northern kingdom. He had said by all his servants, the prophets, so was Israel carried away out of their own land to Assyria unto this day. And the king of Assyria brought men from Babylon, which is your people, right? From Cutha, and from Abar, and from Hamath, and from Sepharim, and placed them in the city of Samaria instead of the chosen of Israel, and they possessed Samaria and dwelt in the cities thereof. And that's what happened. That's why your, because what was the goal of your people following the customs for so long, you consider yourself the Jews. But the thing about being a Jew is you have to be a Jew by nationality. You have to be a tribe of Judah. Okay, it's not a thing where you rehearse it, it's a thing, it's a nationality. Okay, you understand? That's why you call yourself what you call yourself. So what do you want to know, sir?
What I said, just listen.
Okay.
I basically read four holy books.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The Old Testament, the Torah, the Old Testament.
Mm-hmm.
I was basically Muslim.
Okay.
And I started doing a different journey. Not like, oh, I've gone around with it, right? And I believe that all prophets are messengers of God, right, that purify themselves to reach a state. Every single book is the same message, but then when they're all together, the message is deeper, right? It's got a wider perspective. So, for example, now when Moses and Abraham, they came at a time where the people of the nation were interpreting the legend. They know all that text of the legend. Else was into like spiritual healing. So God blessed him with spiritual healing powers. And then Muhammad puts upon him at the time, and that nation was able to receive a revelation in their tongue, because they didn't actually use it, because they had real life. They had really good memories, and they used to storytell and tell poetry. So God blessed him with the Quran, which is such a poetic